ESPN, Jacksonville, Florida. From the Professional Karting Association's National Pro Race, the Entertainment Sports Programming Network presents the second in a series of the Bridgestone National Pro Races.
Chuck Hammond from Jacksonville, Florida for ESPN. We're here covering the Bridgestone Pro Kart Series. And you know, the first time I saw a kart in 1958 in Southern California, there were 2x4 frames, wheelbarrow wheels, and engines from lawnmowers. To tell you how far they've come, here's my good friend and co-host, Gus Trader.
Chuck, this is what they're running for today. Trophies, money, and this is what they're doing it in. A go-kart. This go-kart has come a long way since the days that you were talking about out in Southern California. First of all, the big thing today is the tires. This is one of the biggest things that there's been controversy over. The tires today are soft compounded rubber. They're fairly expensive, but the width is the big thing. They are 8 inches wide in the back, 5 inches in the front. Back when they started, they were probably narrow, 2 inches and 4 inches, and they were 6-inch wheels. These are 5-inch wheels spread out. Okay, the next thing is the tuned exhaust pipes that they use on these machines. They've got a tuned pipe here that'll operate at different speeds. It'll come on better on a long straightaway. They extend them in and out to get better RPMs on the top end or more power on the low end. The next thing is the type of engines they're running today. They're running these fan air-cooled engines without any fan of any kind or flywheel. They used to run strictly flywheel engines to cool them. Today, it's big, thick fins on these engines so that they will cool running down the straightaway. They sit out on the side of the cart where they'll get plenty of air and they'll stay cool and not heat up and seize the engine. Another thing is the type of brakes. Brakes are so important because these carts are going so much faster than they did in the old days. Remember the old scrub brakes where they used to push them piece of steel against a tire and slide through the sand and the dirt when they used to run on them? Today, it's a highly engineered design type of brake made by aircraft companies to stop these carts at high speed. Our gas tanks are plastic. They sit underneath the driver's partition here, underneath the steering, where they will be out of the way, and they're plastic. There's no steel involved so that they will explode and cause damage. But the carts are made of real heavy, a real strong moly, chrome moly steel that are flexible on these bank curves and so forth that you see here further in the afternoon as the racing goes on. Chuck, all these years, the 20 years, it's still a family sport.
This track, Gus, is about 5/8 of a mile in length. It's got quite a few short, sharp turns, but one of the outstanding things about this track in deference to other tracks is that long, long, long back chute. It's 1,000 feet, Gus, and we don't normally see this in the karting annals. What's your opinion of this?
My opinion is something that I think this type of racing, this type of track is good for this high-speed racing that these drivers, these are the fastest single-engine drivers in the business, the fastest karts around, and this long straight gives them time to use that horsepower and speed in order to make a good show out of this and for some outstanding driving. If you've got the power and speed here, you can win. And there's 38 carts in this first race, and as you watch them coming down here, they're dicing in and out, trying to see what's going to happen up there in front. And
starter Bob Allman doesn't like that at all.
No, he's not for that at all, and he's very tough on these starts, and he will, if they do not come down in a decent way, he will put some drivers back farther in the lineup.
Right. Well, Bob's a former national champion. He knows what it's like to sit up there.
He's got to
be under all that pressure.
He's got a great view of this field as it comes down to where he's standing. He's at the end of this 1,000-foot chute, and he's giving these guys plenty of time to get in their position. And he's not going to fool around with them more than once or twice down here on a false start.
That's right. Now, for the fans, the man in the white is Harlan Willis from Oxnard, California. It'll be a little easier for to pick him up. He's number 82. And the number 2 machine, Lynn Haddock in the red up there on the pole.
Right behind Haddock is this young driver, Emmick, number 15. Each driver ran 3 elimination heats yesterday. He finished 3rd in 2 of them and 4th in another. He had acquired enough points to finish and get third starting position.
Okay, Gus, it looks real good. 100cc engines are coming. Let's see if he gives them a go. He gives them a green. Haddock has a slight lead as they go in. Dropping right in behind Harlan Willis and pulling away a couple 3 cart lengths. Now, I talked to Lynn Haddock just early on. He said that's very slippery up in that one corner. Pulling away.
Haddock has got about a 2 cart length ledge over Willis as they go through the Monzas here. There's 3 Monza turns here, and until they come out onto the main chute. Now they're making the big bend into the main chute right now with Haddock opening up probably three carts. But this Willis fellow surprised us in the heat races how he would come on and enter the straightaway.
Right.
Here they come now, and they're opening up a lead over the rest of the field.
Well, attempted passing down that long back chute. You can see from the screen there that Haddock and Willis have pulled out like this. 27 machine running in third, Chip Hilton from Racine, Wisconsin. I think Chip is a little bit heavier.
Chip, weight is such a factor in this type in a kart race. These drivers and carts must weigh a minimum of 300 pounds. You cannot weigh under that. These drivers are scaled as they come off the track after the race, and if they don't make the 300 pounds, they are disqualified for that particular heat or event, the race they've been in. But there's a lot of passing down that straight right now, with Haddock still holding the lead by about three cart lengths over number 82, Willis. Running in the third position, Ronnie Emick, number 15, with Chip Pendleton out of Racine, Wisconsin, dropping back into fourth. One of the drivers that's been really strong in the practice here and in the qualifying heat, only to meet in some disaster and some crashes, was Scott Pruitt, number 8. And we don't know where he's at the moment, but I'm sure that he's working his way up through the pack. He was way back in about 10, 20.
All right, here's Lynn Haddock leading into that front Monza. And Harlan Willis, Gus, staying very close to him. He's doing a fine job. You know, the speeds these fellas are turning may not be recognizable because of the size of the machines. These machines are 6 feet or under. They're running a 100cc engine. That's just 6 cubic inches. Most of them are air-cooled. Some are water-cooled or liquid-cooled. But the amount of horsepower that they get out of these 100cc engines is phenomenal. I would say they're producing probably close to what, 85 miles an hour down that back chute?
Definitely
at the end?
That fast, because it's a long chute. And now we're coming. Here is Ronnie Emick now in the third position, opening up a lead over the fourth and fifth cart. And that's Pendleton, 27 out of Wisconsin, and 24 Scott Sellergren out of Illinois. Rick Gifford and Lake Speed and Ron Pruitt are your. Scott Pruitt are your 6th, 7th, and 8th place drivers. Now, Pruitt has moved up from 24th to 8th. Now, he's the man to watch and see where he can end up in the first heat, because that'll be a determining factor in what he'll do in the next two main events.
That's right. These are straight-up starts based on qualifying times. 3rd and 4th place really putting on a show.
That's Rick Gifford has moved up behind Emick here now. Rick Gifford, number 19 out of California. He's about to take over from Emick. Emick has lost his clutch. Now, Lake Speed and Sellergren and Chip Pendleton and Scott Pruitt are your next 4 or 5 drivers as we go through the Monza.
Perhaps we should explain to them what we mean about losing a clutch. These boys use clutches that run in oil, the object being to keep the RPMs absolutely as high as possible through the corners. Sometimes they get them a little too hot.
Look at this field here now. Look at the passing in the
there.
In the fourth.
4 abreast, 5 abreast there momentarily.
This is the 3rd, 4th, and 5th place
slightly
car.
Touching there. Somebody's got to give ground. You see that bumping?
I think Scott Pruitt moved into the 5th position there. He passed 3 drivers coming down that main chute.
Oh, he's a tremendous chauffeur from Roseville, California. He and his brothers have won something like 7 national amateur championships. Family affair. Mom is here doing the timing. Dad is doing the mechanicing. And he's a great little chauffeur. He had a lot of problems, by the way, in qualifying. Matter of fact, he lost the tire completely out there.
Now, Lake Speed is the driver that's still in front of Scott Pruitt. He's number 1. He's the world champion. He's running right in front of Pruitt. But we have the lineup as now is Haddock, Willis, Gifford, and then Lake Speed and Pruitt. That is your top 5 at the moment. This is your 3rd place driver, Rick Gifford. Here comes Pruitt and Speed. Pruitt just
good
moved
battler. In. Pruitt got by him.
Pruitt just moved into the 4th position. Pruitt is running 4th with Lake Speed 5th, going through the Monzas there. It's a race between Pruitt and Speed.
Again, Lake Speed is the current world champion, having won that event in October in the Le Mans, France, against all the greatest drivers in the world. And by the way, the man who's running in front did all the wrenching for him. Lynn Haddock is his chief mechanic. The reason Lynn doesn't run in those is
why is that, Chuck?
A little bit heavier. And it's a 265-pound weight limit in Europe versus the 300-pound here.
All right, Lake Speed has, I think, got a back ahead of Pruitt here now. They're going through the Monza, coming down into the main chute. Haddock still leading this race over Willis. Rick Gifford, number 19, running third. But now here they come through it on the inside of speed. They're through the corner together, but he backed off. This is quite a battle that Pruitt and Speed are putting on.
Fourth and fifth, is that?
That's fourth and fifth position. And watch that number 24, Stellergren. He's not far behind these two boys.
Right. That's a fine battle there. Lake Speed having all he can handle just to stay ahead of that man. Lake's from Jackson, Mississippi. Very quiet young man. Very intelligent and super cool. He's always, I think, under pressure. He's very, very cool.
There comes Pruitt alongside again.
He's going to make that pass this
time. And he's going to make the pass. He is making the pass. He's looking over at
him. Inside. He's got
it. No, he didn't quite do it.
He didn't. I think Speed dove in a little bit deeper there. Speed knows he's got his hands full. That's a great race. This boy Pruitt is a tremendous chauffeur.
This is a 20-lap event.
First of three today. I tell you, they are really exciting. I imagine you fans can really hear the noise here and the sound of these engines. They all use tuned pipes. They aren't too conscious of being quiet.
Here's Pruitt making his shot again. He's getting up alongside.
He should have it this time.
He's alongside of him. They're coming into a cart.
Oh, they had a slower cart up there that just was positioned in such a manner that I think Speed was able to use it. It could be, though, that one tooth different in gearing is what's doing it. It looks like Lake gets in just a bit deeper there.
Lake is driving the Italian cart, the Burrell cart.
Yes.
And this is a cart that's used highly in the European racing.
That's right. And there's a lot of flexibility to the frame. They're much more conscious of that type of thing over there than we have been here.
Now here's Pruitt again making his bid.
I believe he's got it. This time it looks like he's got it. Let's see if he can stay in there. If he can go in deep, he's got him this time.
He can make the pass. He's back into the fourth position.
If he doesn't go high, he's all right. He's got it now. He's up in the fourth. You know, he told us this morning he had a lot of problems in qualifying, losing the tire. He was involved in a tremendous slip here in one of the heat races, this boy Pruitt. Very confident this morning in talking with him. He says, hey, no problem, I'll be up there. And here he is up in, what, fourth spot now, and he's moved from
24th.
24th, unreal. Tremendous chauffeur.
See, now he'll be in the next main event. He will be starting, if he finishes in the fourth position, he'll be in the second row outside.
Speed making a bid.
Speed is making a bid again to pass him.
No, Speed couldn't quite pull it off. He tried. That section they just went through, Gus, I was up there a few minutes ago. The track is moist there. We're on the white flag. Bob Allman, the starter, indicating one lap to go. My gosh, we've gone through 19 laps already, Gus.
Well, Lynn Haddock is still leading this event. And there he comes, and there comes Willis, running number two.
Checkered flag
on Lynn Haddock. Second one to Harlan Willis, and your third place cart is number 19, Rick Gifford.
Rick Gifford from Gardena, California, who also drives sprint cars.
And here comes Lake Speed. He just passed Pruitt down here, so
Pruitt had a problem.
Speed edged out Pruitt for that fourth spot, so Pruitt ended up. The winner was Lynn Haddock. There he comes, the old Chattanooga choo-choo, ladies and gentlemen.
The Bridgestone National Pro Series continues with the second main event and an interview with this pro carter, Dave Bradley.
Okay, we just saw a spectacular crash in one of the heat races, and involved was young David Bradley, who at the time was running in second position. David, what happened as you came through those mounds with Scott Pruitt, number eight?
Well, it's you know, it's real close through there, and it's hard to say, you know, when you're open wheel racing like that. I don't think anybody was at fault, you know. It's hard to keep from getting together because you're so close through there.
You crashed into those tires pretty hard. Did you suffer any accident or feel from it? Do you feel hurt from it anyway?
No, it didn't hurt me.
From Jacksonville, Florida, the second main event of the Bridgestone Pro Karting Association event. Gus, how are their positions selected for the second main?
Well, they stack up this way, Chuck. They stack up just the way they finished the first event. And as usual, and a very common thing to happen here, Lynn Haddock, number two from Chattanooga, Tennessee, who has won every race he's got into in his pro series, is on the pole after winning this last main. Outside from California, number 82, Harlan Willis, in the third position. Number 19, Rick Gifford. And starting in fourth is number one, Lake Speed, current world champion. Into the fifth starting position, number 24, Scott Sellergren. Into the sixth position is number 51, a Tampa, Florida boy, Sam Rodriguez. This is the fourth row, starting on the inside. Actually, seventh position, a boy with a lot of tough luck, Scott Pruitt, number 8 out of California. This fellow was running in fourth, and the last corner, he lost his clutch, went out, and he finished in the seventh position, lost three positions there real quick. Into the outside in that row is number 20, Jeff Nelson, out of California. And starting in the fifth row on the inside is Bobby Schiffert, number 11, out of California. And in the 10th position, number 17, Jim Bono will work his way up through the pack to get to this position.
They're coming down, Gus.
Okay, they're getting ready for this first lap here.
No start.
Chuck Hammond chatted with the fastest qualifier before the PKA Bridgestone Pro Race.
Lena's a five-time pro winner, ladies and gentlemen, and to get up there, you've really got to have it all together. And I don't think I know another man who has more dedication, more preparation than Lynn Haddock. And Lynn, I guess you agree that's the major portion of it. Once you get it there, the driving isn't that tough?
Well, the driving's tough, but it's a fast-changing sport. Tires change, chassis change, engine change, and the main thing is you have to work with it all the time and stay right on top of the combination that is working the best at the time.
And you, along with Lake Speed, were one of the original men that formed the Professional Karting Association that we're showing here today. Can you tell us how that came about in a short few moments here?
I think it was in 74 we had the initial race in Memphis, Tennessee, which was, to now, the only night race, which was real spectacular. We just felt like that there was a place in karting for guys with experience, extremely fast equipment, just kind of a step above the other 15 or 16 classes that we currently have. Just, you know, and another thing, we felt like that karting to ever go out of the backyard was going to need a promotional vehicle that you could sell to the public. And so far, this Pro Series, 4 or 5 years later, it's been real slow, but with a lot of help and a lot of work from other people, it's worked out real well.
There's a green start, and here they come.
Haddock moves into first, Willis right behind him, and right up there in the second place, a slight bump there where you had a car climb up the rear, up the rear wheels of the car in front of him, but doing okay. Sam Rodriguez, the place boy, really moving up there. He's very surprising. We haven't seen Sam up there before.
Well, Lynn Haddock is still has the lead here with the same way as in the first domain, and Harlan Willis is right on his bumper there as they go through the Monzas. Now, there's, as I said before, there's two or three Monzas in this racetrack with one long 1,000-foot straightaway, and here they come with Haddock in the lead.
Oh,
and
man,
Willis right behind
him. Super exciting race.
And the third position.
Third, fourth, and fifth there.
Where they come now, this third, fourth, fifth
position.
Look
how close they are.
Rick Gifford is holding that. The Lake Speed and Rodriguez and Pruitt, all four of those boys are right together there. And any one of them can take over the lead. Here they go through the first Monza. It's still Gifford and then Speed. Rodriguez is Florida boy and Pruitt. Pruitt's a guy that has shown so much speed and power here, but he just had nothing but bad luck, and he's never got up to the front where he really feels he should be. And
look
here
he's
moving out there now.
But just take a look at that lead that Lynn Haddock has pulled off.
Lynn Haddock has jumped out. Something's happened to Willis. Willis is back in the pack a ways. Rick Gifford has now moved into second spot. And Rick Gifford in third with Rodriguez fourth. And here they go. Your race, ladies and gentlemen, is for second. Chuck, look at the way those guys are hung together there.
Oh, it's unreal. You know, the thing is, the people watching on the screen have no idea the speeds these guys are obtaining. And I would say down at back shoot, they've got to be running up around 85, 87 miles an hour at the end. And they whip these things back and forth. It's just phenomenal to me that they don't get upside down more often than they do. A great race in that pack, that four-pack running for second. Any one of them could be in that spot at an instant. You know, the guy makes a bobble and he loses four places right off the top.
You'll notice a little bumper touching here through the Monzas. These guys are just letting one another know where they're at. And
right.
It's quite thrilling to watch these guys, the way they steer these things through these Monza curves at this speed. They're going 85 miles an hour down that back chute right now, and Rick Gifford has moved out into a little more of a lead in that second position. We're not talking about Lynn Haddock right now because he has got a commanding lead, but the race, ladies and gentlemen, is for the second spot.
Rick, Rick Gifford, a fine young chauffeur from Gardena, California. You know, he's been driving sprint cars out there. He's been trying to get a good ride. He's one of the smoothest drivers I've ever seen. Now, he started 24th this morning in the first main. Here he is up in second position here. He's just a tremendous chauffeur. This is a 5/8 of a mile track, and with these many, many curlicues they have to go through, and the Monzas, it requires an awful lot of agility and capability. And then that long chute, which is so punishing, that back chute is over 1,000 feet long, Gus. Gifford
is running.
19
here
in front of that pack. A little, he's pulling away from his group, and a little action back there among those three men.
It's speed for that third spot now the race seems to be at.
Right.
Gifford is leading second. Ahead of Gifford, then we got Speed, the current world champion. Run right behind him is a Florida boy, number 51, Sam Rodriguez. And there's Haddock, the old pro, just cruising along on a Sunday afternoon.
Yeah, it may look that way, but he's mobiling. He is just so incredibly smooth. He just straightens this track out, makes it look like there's absolutely nothing to it.
Well, he's got about, a 50-foot lead over the nearest car.
Oh, no, much more than that.
There's your second man,
Rick Gifford,
but they've closed the gap on him again, Chuck.
Yes, they did move up slightly.
Lake Speed and Rodriguez and Pruitt. I think Pruitt just sitting back there now. He's just going to play it cool for a while, but I just...
Well, he's another one of the tremendous chauffeurs. He and his brother have won something like 7 national championships, you know, in the amateur ranks before he moved up into the professional karting group.
Boy, he isn't even 20 years old yet, and he's been racing. I can remember Pruitt for years and years in this racing.
That's right. You know, they don't run safety belts or roll bars or
here
anything.
Here comes Lake Speed on the outside of Gifford trying to take
move?
Over that two position.
Is he gonna get him?
There comes Pruitt up alongside Rodriguez.
Oh, boy,
we've got a race into this Monza. Here they come, 4 abreast.
Gifford still got the spot.
Gifford still got, but Speed just took him out.
He sure did. It looked like Gifford went high there.
There comes Pruitt past Rodriguez. You got a lot of changing in that lap.
That number one plaque indicates that he's the current world champion, and that's not a figment of imagination. He won it in Le Mans, France, against all the countries in the world over there, and did a tremendous job.
Lake Speed, world champion in Europe, compares karting in Europe and America.
The way karting is accepted in Europe is much more recognized as far as actual true racing sport. Over there, the public really gets in behind it a lot more. There's a lot, put it this way, I'm a famous person in Europe. In the United States, not near so much. Mm-hmm. It's just because they really appreciate kart racing in Europe. They understand it for what it is.
Lake Speed, now we're on.
He's reaching down to adjust a little bit, Speed is. And there comes,
here comes Gifford
back. There comes Spruitt. They're making some changes in
Gifford
there again.
Gifford got by him.
Gifford
got it back. Moves into that second slot. You know what's happening? They're closing up behind him now, too. There's 5 cars. See that one man get airborne as he ran over that cement in the corner there.
Yeah, you find Willis back in the contention now. He's back up to 8th place. Something happened up there in the first and last. But right now, we've got this race here for second spot between Haddock and the second place man is quite a distance.
Real battle for that group back there in that second place. And there's a pass again. There goes Speed. He's getting by Gifford. I can't believe it. And Pruitt is right there also. We're back on Lynn Haddock now. Lynn was telling me that spot he just went by has got a lot of moisture in it. The heat after the rain has sucked the water up out of the track there. Gifford got it back.
And Pruitt is now in third spot, challenging Gifford. Pruitt has moved up. Speed is ready.
Show up there. Rick Gifford. Watch this Pruitt boy. Let's see what he can do. He just may blow right by Rick Gifford. This Pruitt entry, the second car that you see on the screen there, this young fella is a tremendous chauffeur.
You see Willis, the boy in the white, has moved up into contention. Pruitt is trying to get outside on Gifford. There seems to be moving in and out on that straightaway. Look at him strung out there. There's six carts there. Any one of them can take the second spot.
And that's the battle. That's where it's at.
Willis has moved back up past Sellergren into the, I'd say, about the seventh spot. Jeff Nelson is out of the race.
You know, $20,000, Gus. These guys aren't going to back off. This is a pro series. They're after that big pot.
They seem to resolve themselves the fact that Lynn Haddock can't be caught. And he's just pulling away here by quite a lead.
Excuse me for interrupting, but down this back chute, they can use a draft. You see him pull out there hoping to slingshot? A little too late, though. They actually, at 85 miles an hour, do get actually pulled along in a vacuum to a degree.
Here they come through the curves here.
Rick Gifford still holding it. Pruitt on his bumper, just trying every move he can make.
Well, he's got speed on his bumper. He can't do nothing.
Speed is behind him, that's right. So you got Gifford, Pruitt, Lake Speed, a little bumping there.
That's somebody up on somebody.
went up on a wheel there.
Yeah.
And they lost, you see what they lost, about 10 or 12 feet there, just in that little action.
There's Willis. He's back now up challenging for fifth.
This boy Willis ran, and there goes a pass. Is that?
That's Willis moving up. Here he comes on the outside of all of them.
Gifford's still trying to hang in there, and this Willis has made, he made three pass. He got two cars there, I guess it was.
He did. He's now up into third spot behind Gifford. He wants that second spot. He made it.
He took Pruitt with him.
Took Gifford. Pruitt followed right through there.
Here comes Gifford. He tried to get by and went up on the rear wheels there.
What action we've got here in this second main event, as this guy Willis, some reason or other, got in the first or second lap, lost about eight positions. He's got himself back up to second. He's pulling away a little bit from Pruitt. I should say he and Pruitt are pulling away from the rest of the boys.
Here comes Lake Speed by there. That's the number one machine. Oh, I tell you, this is a tremendous race in this group here.
But now, you notice they're spreading out a little more. Willis and Pruitt are moving away from the Sellergren and Speed and Rodriguez.
You stop and think about it, you got a 300-pound machine, or that's total, man machine, with about 22 horsepower. You figure out the ratio of the
power to weight.
It's, you know, you can see what's happening. These guys are just really milking every ounce of performance out of him. Now, Lake Speed has suddenly dropped back there just a moment. He's reaching over to tune that carburetor, Gus, trying to get a little bit more pony out of it. That's the air and gas mixture, air and methanol mixture in their case.
Lynn Haddock has opened up about 300 feet on the nearest card, and that is number 82 and number 8, who are battling for that second spot right now. That's Willis and Pruitt.
Machine there.
Scott Sellergren, number 24, has come from somewhere, from nowhere really, to move up into fourth here.
He's a Park Ridge, Illinois boy, and we noticed in qualifying he looked real strong out there, Gus.
I didn't know Pruitt was even behind Willis till they come down the chute here for a ways, and you could see him drafting right directly behind Willis down through that main chute. Look at how close they get as they go through these sections here.
Well, it's side by side, elbow to elbow in many cases. And you know, they're only a couple inches off the ground, but that makes for kind of a safe arrangement, too.
I'm watching Bob Allman right now. He has got his eyes strictly on Willis and Pruitt, the number 82 and number 8 drivers. He's watching those because he knows this is going to be a close finish between these two, and they're coming down the chute, and he's watching for nothing that's going to be wrong in the way they drive.
That's right, and he knows that both those drivers are capable of winning the whole thing if they could get up there. So, and he also knows that they have great skill, and they're not going to run into each other, not going to bang each other if they can help it, because that costs some time, actually. You see how close they are there? They're within a couple of inches of each other.
They're going through their Mazdas at a high rate of speed, and now they're coming into the main chute, and here's where they'll attain at about 85 miles an hour down that back chute.
I think we clocked them the other day at 87.4 miles at the end of the chute.
There's Pruitt on the inside of Willis.
Not going to make it, though.
He backs off.
He tried to slingshot there, but didn't have enough horsepower to carry him on around.
In the qualifying heats early today, Scott was running in second or third position, and he and young David Bradley came through a Mazda together, and they both locked wheels and went out of the race, costing him valuable starting position.
Oh, yes. It was a tremendous flip, actually.
And Scott is not going to do that again, I'm sure of that. This is for the money, this main event, and he's going to play it as cool as he can.
Moves up to the outside to see if he can do something there. They have tremendous acceleration in these little machines. Coming around those Mazdas, they're probably turning in the 60, 65 mile an hour area. And you know, they just touch the brake, stay right on the throttle, just kind of point the machine around there. They really do a tremendous job of these. And they make it look so easy. You know, it's not that simple. I guess it's like any form of automobile racing or open wheel racing.
There's your leader, Lynn Haddock.
Lynn Haddock is just motoring past the other driver.
I think he's coming around now. The flagman has a white flag in his hand. I'm sure this is going to be the white flag lap for Lynn Haddock when he comes by the starter.
A few years ago, we gave him the nickname of the Chattanooga Choo-Choo, and it's stuck, and he certainly is worthy every bit of it.
Here he comes.
Starter Bob Allman is out with a white flag, getting ready to greet Lynn Haddock to indicate one to go. And there's your starter. Everybody getting the white now. We're on the final lap. Apparently going to be no changes.
There shouldn't be any changes
in that front row. However, with Pruitt and Willis, or Willis and Pruitt in the actual positioning up there, we ought to pick them up and take a look at it, because that could be the race. There you see him.
Now you're going to find Pruitt is going to be right on Willis. coming through the Monzas and come down on the straightaway.
Now here they come down on the
lower.
Here
they come now.
Right
here they come down the main.
Okay, we're on Lynn Haddock now coming into the final Monza. He'll be wrapping around, coming down for the checkered flag from starter Bob Allman.
Here they come. Here comes
this
Willis.
This guy has won, and here's Willis and Truett. So they'll start in these positions based on the next time around, our third heat. Their positions will be determined by their total points, which means the positions they finished in each of the two previous mains.
Well, Chuck Lynn Haddock has done it again. He's won his second main, and this fellow has not been defeated now in the three heat races in Quincy and the three mains in Quincy. Won them all. He now has won all three of his elimination heats down here, and he's now won the first two main events. He's got his hands on no lower than third place in this event.
That's right.
So a lot of depend on where he, if he gets all the gold in the last main event. But Lynn Haddock was your winner, with Harlan Willis dropping back into eighth position, working his way back up to second to finish second in this event, and he is now standing real strong.
We're showing
for
a picture on the scales here. What's happening is the machine and the driver get on the scales to make sure they meet that minimum 300-pound weight. They have to meet that. As a matter of fact, any time in a race, the starter can call them or a race director can call them over and say, I want to weigh you and your machine. And they have to be that, even in practice.
The PKA Bridgestone National Pro Series third main event in just a moment.
In position number 22, Tom Hunter Jr. And in eighth is number 19, Rick Gufford, who's dropped back. He had a little clutch problem in the last main. In the ninth position is number 27, Chip Pendleton, who's been up and down. And starting in 10th is number 68, Leroy Wilkerson. Here we go now.
We're on green.
There's the green flag, and we go into the first corner with Haddock and Willis and
Lakespeed
moves into the third spot.
Lake got a little airborne there, but he's okay. Seligren sitting in fourth.
Here we go now with Lynn Haddock and Willis, one and two.
Pulling away slightly.
And Gifford.
This is the big one.
There it comes. Haddock pulling away a little bit again. He just seems to.
Look at that pack coming down that back chute. You know they're hitting around 85 miles an hour as they pass our starter there, who's giving him the continuing green.
This
into
is
the Monza.
This is the first lap, a 20-lap final main event here, and Haddock has a leg on it. We're sitting here now with the race, with Haddock leading Willis by about two cart lengths. Following right through behind them then is your next three carts. And you'll see Seligren and Pruett and Lakespeed all there bunched together.
It's 24, 8, and 1. Okay, your two machines sitting out in front. Lynn Haddock starting to pull away now from the white-clad Harlan Willis from Oxnard, California. Look at that drafting and that shooting out of the in that long chute. That's 1,000 foot back there, Gus. Lakespeed doing a very fine job. He's the current world champion, running in third now.
Yeah, but Pruett is right alongside of him, with Seligren right behind him. And number 22, Tom Hunter, has moved up into a challenge position. He's number 22 in the red outfit. But it's Speed and Pruett, Seligren and Hunter running for that third spot. It seems our racing most of the day has been for that second and third position, Chuck.
Yeah, it seems like the pack that forms back there. Look at that pass. Look at that pass. He slingshot past him like a NASCAR down at Daytona. Did you see them go around there? That's fantastic.
That's Pruett. Pruett has moved into that third position
and
now.
Scott Pruett from Roseville, California, going by the world champ, Lakespeed.
And if he wants to get up in the top three, he has to stay in that position in order to get into the third, you know, into the third place money. He has a third so far, and he has a seventh, Scott has. But Lakespeed, he's got a fourth and a fifth, so he's just as good a position as he is right now.
That's
so
right.
The race is really for the third place money in its last main, as long as Haddock stays and Willis stay where they're at.
This but is a $20,000 series. How far down do they pay?
They pay 15 places in each race, Chuck.
Oh, Lakespeed goes over the Monzetter. There he is. They got him. They got him on there. Lakespeed, the man inside of him went in a little too deep, forced him up, and actually helped keep the other man in. And Lake went over the bank slightly, but got back on the track. He lost three or four places there, unfortunately.
I think that was a race between Pruett and Speed coming down that chute. Okay, there's Bono. Bono is running. That's Jim Bono. Chuck probably knows this boy better than I do.
Jim Bono's from Wauwatosa, Wisconsin. He's been trying for many, many years, and he's a tremendous driver, has great equipment. He really didn't seem to be running that good in qualifications, but he just hangs in there, and he's moving up all the time. He's just doing a fine job. That's the 17 machine on your screen right now.
I see Lake Speed trying, number one, trying to work his way back up to the pack back here, but right now our race is up there for that third spot. And your leader at the moment, there's Jim Bono in the yellow and green. Jim, about 1976, put on a tremendous show. He really got to be well known in that race. He came from nowhere to take second place in the pro race at Quincy, Illinois. And since then, Jim has been a contender, but he's never got the big one. So here we go now. Scott Pruitt is number eight. He's trying to pick up on the leaders. He's running in the third position, got quite a lead over the rest of the pack. I noticed Bono was starting to tune there a little bit. He must have some problems. He's dropped back again.
Well, they try to get the most horsepower they can out of that engine. And, of course, what you see him doing with that right hand is reaching down and tuning that carburetor. They've got two needles, a high speed and a low speed.
Tom Hunter has moved, I think, into the fourth position.
There's a shot of our leader, the Chattanooga Choo-Choo, Lynn Haddock. Old Mr. Cool, always prepared, does a job. He's the biggest winner so far on the Pro Series.
Chuckie's in good shape here today.
He is always the man to beat. You know, you wonder why he doesn't win in Europe. He's a little bit heavier than Lake Speed, so he goes over and does the wrenching.
Okay, Harlan Willis. Harlan Willis in the white uniform is still running in second, but watch for Pruitt back there. He's coming down. He's not too far behind Willis. And remember the last race, he and Willis had quite a battle for that second spot. So this could occur again, Chuck, these two drivers.
Well, you know, you just can't really tell how tremendous these guys are. It looks so simple out here, so easy. And I guess it's true of all kinds of racing. We're up to Formula One. If you've got the ability, you make it look simple. And you and I have been very impressed here during qualifying and during practice by some of these drivers. And we're seeing him perform out there against the best in the U.S., Mexico, and Canada.
Here comes Pruitt now. Here's your top three. Haddock, Harlan Willis, number 282, and then Pruitt, number eight. And they're coming down the main chute through the Monza.
There's our Roseville, California entry, Scott Pruitt.
Here comes Pruitt. He's trying to pick up that ground on Willis. Don't seem like he's gaining too much.
Then we have, doesn't appear to be running like he was earlier before that crash.
Jeff Nelson has moved off into the fourth position, ladies and gentlemen. This young driver is way down the line, and some...
Is that Pruitt?
Pruitt is having problems.
Pruitt moving up high, not running good at all. As we've mentioned, we just indicated a moment ago, it appeared that he was not doing the job. Something has gone amiss. We can't tell just yet. He's still running. He might have a broken piston ring or some such thing. Still running, but not putting out the power.
This can happen to anyone. You know, Lynn Haddon, something could happen to one of his engines here, and it might cut him out of that first place money.
Well, I remember when Lynn was leading one here a few years ago, and his carburetor came off, or came loose, and he had to drive, trying to hold on to it. Tremendous race going on here between Lake Speed, trying to get around the sixth entry there.
That's Greg Mayer.
Doug Mayer, right, from up in Wisconsin, Grafton, Wisconsin. He's come on real well. There's a couple of these boys, brothers, the Mayer brothers, and he's pulling away from Lake Speed. Lake's current world champion, yet
that didn't
boys
help.
From Wisconsin have come a long, long way.
Chuck, that did not help Lake to go off that mountain in that sand.
No,
he probably stuck some sand into his carburetor, causing to really take the life out of his engine and piston rings, you know. You just don't have the snap like you had.
That's right.
So
off the edge of that Monza, it's all soft dirt. We had quite a rain here yesterday, and the chances are good that he did indeed suck up some sand into that carburetor. But there was a picture of Scott Pruitt holding up his hand and the normal gesture, gentlemen, I'm going slower. Please watch it as you go by. Tough break for a real fine young chauffeur.
The 72 car driver, Tommy Nolting,
a local boy from Jacksonville, Florida. He's been
coming
heavy fire. I noticed how he's been smoking. A lot of problems.
Tommy qualified real good here, but he's had a lot of bad luck in the race itself.
Well, you know, they don't get a chance to run against the big boys very often. Here's Lynn Haddock, the Chattanooga Choo-Choo. He's just so calm, so cool, into the Monza, over the slippery, slidey port part there, and just kind of straightens these S's out like a Sunday afternoon drive.
The exciting conclusion of the third main event in just a moment.
You know, Chuck, we're running our third main event. This is 20 laps in each main. These fellas had to run 45 laps of heat races. So in order to win this race, they've got to run 105 laps. They're now in their last 10 laps of this race. And you see, these engines are getting tired.
Yeah, it's tough on them and tough on the engines. You know, it's quite humid here in Jacksonville, Florida. We had a tremendous rain yesterday, and the sun this morning has caused that moisture to come up. It's very tough on the drivers, and the equipment does get tired, that's for sure.
The driver you see right here is number six, Mayer out of Wisconsin.
Doug Mayer, right.
He's losing his number panel on the rear of the cart, which is no danger because that is plastic, and it will not cause any problems when it fly up into the cart.
Well, try as they might to secure all this stuff, but with a two-cycle engine causing those explosions so frequently, it's kind of tough to keep everything on there.
There goes Mayer. He's
very, very close. They drive this way. They're probably in the Monzas are around 65 miles an hour and 2 inches apart, maximum. They know each other. They know how they drive, and they all drive pretty much the same.
They're coming down the chute now, switching position. And it's still Mayer. And there goes Shepard in low on it.
You know, you rarely see a crack up or a spill, but once in a while, somebody gets over anxious and climbs a wheel. Then you might see a tremendous flip. But rarely do the boys get hurt because they're so close to the ground. And they learn early on that you sort of kick the cart away from you when you're flipping through the air. That's why, ladies and gentlemen, they don't wear safety belts. They don't have roll bars. They are not affixed to the machine. They actually want to come apart from it. They spill.
Chuck, here's the white flag on the leader, Lynn Haddock, or in their last lap. Running second yet is Harlan Willis, number 82. And Scott Pruitt's still out there, but he's back in the pack. Jim Bono just went off the track. He's out of the race. Your third place card is number 20, Jeff Nelson, in the blue outfit. Lynn Haddock taking the victory lap here. This is the final lap. He has won every race he's entered here in this event.
Yes, he has.
And here he comes around. He's coming down the main event, or the main chute now. Coming around, there's a checkered flag on Lynn Haddock. Here's your second place finisher, Harlan Willis, number 82 from California. And we'll know who the third place finisher here in a minute. He'll become, there comes number 20, Jeff Nelson, who is running, finished third. So that's your finish, ladies and gentlemen, of your final main event here at Jacksonville,
Almost
Florida.
Almost had a pass there right at the checkered flag. Very, very close. Some of the boys not in contention down the line a ways, but still not backing off. Well, they said the man to beat was the guy by the name of Lynn Haddock out of Chattanooga, Tennessee, and it was certainly proven. Here he's going down the back chute, shaking hands with Harlan Willis, the man that finished second. Great sportsmanship in this a group of carters. As a matter of fact, I've seen them on occasion where one man barred his...
There goes the checker flag.
...most feared adversary. Here's your checkered flag lap with Lynn Haddock. I've seen him where they loan an engine to the competitor that stood the best chance of beating him, and loan him the best engine. So we're following Lynn Haddock around with a checkered flag, and the fans here are standing and showing their appreciation. The entire group really giving him a hand because he's won, as you say, all three of the main events. He won all three of the qualifying events. He is the current leader in the Pro Series, the $20,000 Bridgestone Pro Series. He'll be shooting now for Medford, Oregon this fall on the ESPN network up there, and I'm sure he will give a good account of himself up there.
Well, you know, Chuck, not only do they win money here today, but there is a contingency fund of money that's put in there, and at the end of the year, the guys that have finished, or the gals, the drivers that have finished the highest, will get more money at award at the end of the year. And this more or less wraps it up down here in Jacksonville as far as the racing is concerned. It's been my pleasure doing these events over the 20 years that we've been around karting. We've seen them come and go. But this guy Haddock has been around for a long time.
You just saw starter Bob Allman congratulate him on a fine, clean race.
He's getting a hand by the fans over there by the scale. He'll go in now. Now, the last thing they'll do before they actually make it official is these engines are impounded and checked for legality to make sure that nothing about them is illegal, which we have yet to find one that was. These fellas have not come to a race like this, get up in the top money, and then find that they've got an illegal engine to win. This is something that very seldom happens, but they still check them.
Well, and well they should, because there is a 6.05 total cubic inch displacement allowance, plus overbore, roughly 100 cc. That's the class that we call this. And they check four stroke, make certain that they are within that spec. Prior to this, of course, they've all gone through the technical aspect. All of the nuts have to be wired on. Weights have to be, if in fact they need weights to meet their 300-pound weight call-out, that has to be wired on in a certain position with certain types of wire. The muffler is fixed on a certain way. Everything is teched out before they ever get on that track for safety reasons. And, well, it might be because, as you saw them down this back chute, Gus, they're traveling 85 miles an hour. We've seen them blow tires and things, not get in too much trouble, but we just don't want to invite trouble. So the Professional Karting Association rules are very stringent on how you operate. Now, right now, Lynn has just pulled up onto the scale, and he will probably get up and stand on the machine, the two of them. The machine, the man, has to weigh the 300 pounds. Getting congratulations from competitors, as well as his pit crew, the Haddock pit crew. They're very, very proud of this man, and they really should be.
Professional Karting Association's Bridgestone Pro Series continues after this pit stop.
All was the great Lynn Haddock of Chattanooga. It's awards time here at Jacksonville, Florida, and Chuck, I had the privilege of presenting the top awards to the top 20 drivers, and here are the first three. Lake Speed was a third place finisher, Harlan Willis was second, and the champion of it all was the great Lynn Haddock of Chattanooga, Tennessee. And now, Lynn is giving the customary champagne shower to the crowd. A true champion.
There you have it, another Bridgestone Pro Karting event, and it was tremendous. This guy, Lynn Haddock, just keeps on winning, Gus.
He certainly does, and it's a pleasure watching him race, and it's a pleasure working with you, Chuck.
Thank you.
We're looking forward to holding more karting events and more fun on ESPN in the future.
Cameras given a lift by Parklift. Promotional consideration given to North Florida Parklift Incorporated.